Another way we can modulate signals in our synth is by creating an LFO, or Low Frequency Oscillator. Let's take a look at how to get an LFO set up in SynthEdit 1.2. In the last couple of videos, we used an ADSR envelope to modulate the volume of the notes we played. Another way that we can modulate signals is with a low-frequency oscillator. Earlier, we used an oscillator to actually produce sound, but an LFO is an oscillator that provides a continuously cycling signal which does not produce sound, used to modulate parts of our synth, like the volume or the pitch. If used on an instrument's pitch, an LFO can be used to simulate vibrato. To set up an LFO, first, add a container inside of the synth container. In fact, let's name the container with the synth in it to synth. If I close down the window and reopen, the name will update. Synth. Now, add a container inside of the synth container and rename it to LFO. Double-click the LFO container to open it up. There won't be any inputs to the LFO, only an output, so I'll move the I/O mod to the right side of the container. Let's add an oscillator to this container, so open up Waveform and select Oscillator. We want to be able to select the waveform that the oscillator uses, so we need to add a list entry module to be able to select it. Go to Controls, select List Entry, and hook it up to the waveform plug. There are two values we can adjust with an LFO, the rate and the depth. The rate is how fast the modulation repeats, and the depth determines the amount that the signal is modulated. To control these values, we need two sliders. I'll name the first one rate, and the second one depth. Hook the rate slider up to the pitch plug on the oscillator. Under parameters, set the low value to negative 10 and the high value to 0. To control the depth, we want to multiply the value that the oscillator is producing by the value provided by the slider. To multiply values, we can use the level adjust module. You can find level adjust under modifiers. Add the level adjust module to the LFO container, and connect the audio out on the oscillator to the input 1 plug on the level adjust, and then hook the depth slider up to the input 2 plug. Finally, connect the output on the level adjust to the I/O mod. At this point, the depth slider is producing a range of voltage between 0 and 10 volts. That's a bit too much for our LFO. You can leave the max value to 10 if you'd like, but it'll sound better if you lower it. You'll get a much more subtle effect. I'll set the maximum value of the depth slider to 2.5 volts. All we have to do is connect the output on the LFO container to the signal that we'd like to modulate. I'll hook it up to the pitch of the oscillator. If I play a note, you can hear how the LFO has affected the signal. If I turn the rate down, the LFO takes a longer period of time to complete one cycle. If I turn the rate up, but turn the depth down, I can get a subtle vibrato effect. And with the shape, we can choose the waveform we'd like to use to modulate the signal. A sine wave gives a smoother sound for vibrato. The LFO is a commonly used component in modular synthesis, as it can add a lot of life to the sound. You can get some really crazy and drastic effects if you put some higher depth values. Don't forget, the LFO can be hooked up to any signal you'd like to modulate. You can modulate the pitch, the volume, pan a signal left and right, anything else you can think of.